at Scrabble. Anne's really good. She's one of those people that routinely gets like 300 points in a two-player game. She's insanely good. And she has this weird like Scrabble food where she just makes magic happen on the board. And I'm usually sort of like, she's Jim Dark Magic and I'm Binwin Set on Fire. That's kind of how it happens. She's the Acid Pit and I'm AFL. Like, that's how it happens. So this is a story about playing Scrabble with my wife. Well, that's sort of what it's about on one level. But if you're married or in a long-term relationship with someone, you'll know that it's about something else entirely. It's called Triple Word Score. It was originally published on December 30th, 2008. And I think this was originally published in a column that I wrote for the LA Weekly. My wife, Anne, is one of those Scrabble players who regularly scores between 350 and 400 points in a two-player game. I am one of those Scrabble players who was lucky to break 150 without opening the dictionary to find out if the collection of mysterious glyphs laid out before him can somehow be assembled into a legal word that is more complicated than one you would find in a Dick and Jane book. I do not provide even a nominal challenge, and where the average player would experience something akin to fun while playing the game, I experience only frustration. Yet my wife insists that we play together. Making words is fun, she says, oblivious to my failure to use all my letters even once in the decade we've been playing. That's right, no bingos for Will. But since she puts up with me describing everything in the world in RPG terms, for example, some idiot cast Freezing Cloud out there. Like, I thought I would have picked up some Resist Cold with all my trips to Seattle, but I just took 1d8 ongoing 15 feet to the garage and back, and I keep failing my saves even though I'm back in the house. This is bullshit. To the more mundane, Wizard needs food, badly. So the very least I can do is provide some companionship while my wife makes the Scrabble board and me her bitch. For several months, I've been able to avoid the humiliation of putting my Scrabular impotence on full display. When she asked me to play last night after dinner, her breathtaking beauty, illuminated only by the twinkle lights on our Christmas tree and the flickering glow of our fireplace. My wife is awesome, you guys. She is awesome. I know. Somehow she stays married to me. I don't know. I failed my save versus charm because she got the plus 20 you're madly in love with me bonus. And I went directly to our game closet. I looked past games that would be fun for me to play. Battle Lore, that's two-player game. Carcassonne, Guillotine, Awful Green Things from Outer Space, Uno, enslaved by her spell, I pulled Scrabble off the shelf and took it to the living room. Our dogs curled up on the floor next to us as we began to play. I reached into the bag of tiles and drew an X. She reached into the bag of tiles and drew an E. It was an unnecessary harbinger of things to come. She went first and instantly took a 20-point lead. I scored 7. Much better than usual. 4 or 5 turns later, she played sexy for a triple word score, and I never caught up. It was a blowout. I was Custer, little bighorn. It was Varro and Kane. The Broncos in Super Bowl 24. The very slim piece of the Venn diagram that's like also football fans was just like, oh, dude. With about 20 tiles remaining in the bag, I saw a chance to draw within 40 points. I had QIEEB. After I had played an ineffectual 2 letters for a humiliating 3 points. If I drew a T, N, or an R, I could place the Q on a triple word score, build off the U in fugue, make quiet, queer, or queen. reached into the bag, drew the T, and held my breath. For Murphy's Law of Scrabble is this. With 85 potential places to play, your opponent will always play in the one place that leaves you thoroughly fucked. And put down two tiles, building off the F in fugue, and blocking me. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? It's a bundle of sticks, she said. I know what it is! But you couldn't have made a wag, or tag, or nag, or hag. I pointed to four of the 85 potential places she could have played on the board. Oh, I'm sorry, she said. You want me to play at a different place? I will, it'll be the same score. This is how it always is when we play games together. My wife is not competitive. She is blissfully unaware of my anguish as I attempt to match her score. She does not know that I consider it a moral victory if she does not double my score. No, I said, I will find another place to play. 5 minutes later, I found it, put my tiles down. I get 2 points. Go me. She recorded my score. I noted that she was not doubling my score by 10 points, and I resolved to close the gap, and failed. With only a U and an I to play, I was down by over 100 points, and I just wanted the game to be over. Okay, I play the U here and I make Vux, I said. What's Vux? She said. Oh, don't you know? That's what it's called when you suck so hard at Scrabble that you just make up a word so that the goddamn game can be over. It's like, oh dude, my wife kicked my ass so hard at Scrabble I totally just went for the Vux. She looked at me and she slowly shook her head. I took the tile off the board and replaced it with an I. Vix, she said. Yeah, Vix is what it's called when you try to Vux and your wife cock blocks you. I don't know, I totally tried to Vux, but then my wife was like, I'm gonna Vix you. She looked at me and she laughed. I joined her. I concede. I said, you are the ultimate master of Scrabble. She leaned over the board and kissed me. Really miss my wife. I miss little things like holding her hand when we take a walk. Thanks for playing with me, she said. I love you. I love you too. Our gaming philosophy is very simple. It's not about winning or losing. It's about enjoying the time that you spend when you are playing together. This is why Anne puts up with all of my vuxing, and I come back for more. Even when she fixes me. The end.